All right. Hello, everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. Today, in front of us, we have a question. Actually, this question came from one of you who sent me a very simple question saying, do we Christian believe that Adam is a prophet? And obviously, this person, he heard the Muslims speaking of Adam as a prophet. You know, the idea of Adam to be a prophet, it's very funny and very unique. It's unique in the way of how silly it is. You see, in order to be a prophet, I have to be sent to people who speak the language of my tongue, and there is people there. So now we have Adam, and Adam was alone, and then God, he made for him Eve. So Adam was a prophet for who? Read with me carefully. As you see, this is not my this is Islamic website. All right, this is islamcad.info, and this is fatwa number 10551, as you see in the top. The first of the prophet is the first of the messengers. I would like to know, Adam, peace be upon him, was a prophet? If he was not, who was the first prophet? The origin and the history of Islam. All right. Okay. Now the answer is coming. Now the answer is coming from a very high educated Muslim scholar, supposedly his name, Sheikh Muhammed Salih al-Munajjid. He's very well known, actually, this guy. Okay, his name is here. You can see him. You see the name in the down in the corner. He said, "Adam, peace upon him, was the first prophet, as it says in the hadith narrated by Ibn etc. That the prophet etc. who was asked about Adam, was he a prophet? So somebody asked Muhammad. You know, I'm so grateful that somebody asked Muhammad this question. So was he a prophet? He said yes." A prophet to whom Allah spoke. A prophet to whom Allah spoke. That's a good one. Any Muslim can translate to me, what does that mean? I mean, we need interpretation for this. This is a story by itself. He is a prophet to whom Allah spoke. But he was not a messenger. That's even more funny. Abdul, I love you. Unbelievable. Abdul, how somebody is a prophet but he is not a messenger? Let me break it down for you. I mean, you Muslims, your intelligence is super duper. If I am God, for sure I'm not, and I'm just just to give an example, and then I say to you something which is a prophecy, which means you are going to prophesy to this to your people, isn't it? This is a message from God, and that will make you a messenger. You know how he can, you see, it's possible that somebody can be a messenger but he is not a prophet, but to be a prophet but you are not a messenger, that's impossible. It's because the second we say a prophet, that's mean this person is delivering a prophecy from God. A messenger can be a messenger of anyone. The postman can be a messenger. A delivery guy can be a messenger. But when we give the title of a prophet to someone, he is not prophesying in his own. He is giving us a delivery, a message from God. This is about something will happen now or something will happen in the future. That will make him a prophet and a messenger at the same time. So it's very stupid to say that there is someone, he is a messenger, but he is not a prophet. The ignorance is amazing. I just received actually a message from overseas. They are trying to set me, you know, like you know, a date for the coming seminar. So anyway, he is a prophet, but he is not a messenger. Why? Because the hadith about intercession, in which says the people will go to Noah and say to him, "You are the first messenger whom Allah sent to earth." That's a good one. So now we have Adam is the first prophet and Noah is the first messenger. I mean, that's a good one. Unbelievable. You know, stupidity is amazing. Just to show you how this false cult contradict itself and how funny and how stupid it is. Adam is a prophet, he is not a messenger. The first messenger is Noah. Stop. So why you Muslims, you claim that the first one who built the house, which means the Kaaba, is, you know, is Adam, and he asked his people to follow it, to go around it and recycle around it in order to be forgiven? See, this is a message. This is not a prophecy. Prophecy is about something will happen in the future. Let us see. Let us see and love together. I know. Sometimes the stupidity of the Abduls is beyond imagination. This is a book. It's called Routes of the and Rename, The Power of Place in Earth Islamic Worlds. All right. You know, etc. Anyway, I don't know who's the writer, but anyway, he is copying what the Muslims are saying. Anyway, so God ordered Adam to build a house of worship, Bait, on earth. And those Muslims, they should be supposedly go around this Kaaba, the same as the angels of Allah, they go around his throne. Okay. So when Allah, actually the hadith in Arabic, it says that Allah, he ordered Adam and Eve to build a house. So Adam used to build and dig, and Eve, she used to carry, which means like Eve, she was the hard labor guy who have a very strong muscles. You know what it means? Let me get you a hadith. Hold on. Hold on. Yeah. Imagine Adam and Eve. All right, here we go. All right. It says here in Arabic, I wish I can find you the one, this one in English. It says that Allah, he sent Jibreel to Adam. Ba'ath Allah ta'ala Jibreel ila Adam wa Hawa fa qala lahuma ibniya li baytan. Fa khatta lahuma Jibreel fa ja'ala Adam yahfur wa Hawa tanqul. حتى أجابه الماء ونودي من تحته حسبك يا آدم. Let me translate. So Allah, he sent Jibreel and he told to tell Adam and Eve, both of them, build for me a house. And he made a plan for them. You know, he made like a line in the ground where they can, we should build a house. And Adam, he started digging. And Eve, she start carrying like the dirt until water came out, you know, and a voice came from underneath of him, says, "Oh, be careful, Adam." And here suddenly the story changed direction, and then say, and then it says, so when he and so when he built the house, Allah ordered Adam to go and circulate around it. And he told him, "You are the first one to do that." All right. Muslims, Allah ordered Adam to circulate around the house. And then Adam, He told them, the people, that Allah told me to circulate around the house. Isn't it, this is a message, and that would make him a messenger from Allah? So he, how he is a prophet, but not he's not a messenger. But I like the story of Adam of Eve. I mean, it's like I want to get Eve like that. That will be wonderful. I will dig, she will carry the dirt. I wonder where I can find an Eve like this. That would be fantastic. You know, these days, women, if they do laundry, they cry for a week. Even the laundry machine is just like you put the clothes there and you hit the bomb and that's it. Still, they are complaining about doing laundry. Look at this Eve and how amazing it is. Adam is digging, Eve is carrying the dirt. I love it. If there's any Eve around, let me know. So how you Muslims, you say, I mean, this is stupid things. Adam to dig and build a house for him. Why Allah don't build a house for himself? And why, I mean, why Mecca? I mean, you know, somebody can tell me. And why the location of Mecca, I mean, the Kaaba, is a very bad location where always it's flooded by bad water and sewage. If we go right now, go and type in Google the flood of the Kaaba. I mean, if Allah is an engineer and he is the one who chose the location, that's mean he is the worst engineer ever. He chose the lowest point of Mecca where all the dirty water come to it when there is a flood. So the Muslims, when they speak about Adam is a messenger, sorry, a prophet, but not a messenger, that is showing us that those people, they are living in a fiction mood. He is a prophet, but he is not a messenger. Noah is a messenger, but he is not a prophet. You know, Adam was a messenger, sorry, he was a prophet to who? Muslims. And what his prophecy? Based on the Quran, I want a Muslim to tell me the prophecy. As we know in the Quran, that Allah, he taught Adam the names of the things. That's not a prophecy. That's not a prophecy. If somebody taught me the names, I'm not prophesying. If somebody told me that this book, this dog, his name is Balbula. He gave the name, and this is not a prophecy. You can give him a different name. That will not make you a prophet too, or make you God. And actually, the story about Allah taught Adam all the names, it is stolen from the Old Testament, but because Muhammad is a corrupt man, he corrupted and he make it so funny and very stupid. Because the angels, they say to Allah, are you going to create someone, he will do mischievement? This is why there's a huge part of Muslims to believe that Adam is not the first man. There was people before Adam. There's a huge part of the Muslims, I made a video about it not long time ago, you can go and watch it, speak about this issue. They are so confused to the point they believe that Adam was not the first man. And why they say that? Because the Quran is saying a stupid story. When the Quran said that Allah, he told Adam, let me find you the claim of the Muslims. when Allah, he told he said he is going to create a human being, the angels said to him, are you going to create someone who would do mischief in the earth? So the Muslims, this group of Muslims, they believe that there is a group of people who live before Adam for sure. And this is an example, the Ahmadiyya believe in that. This is the website of Al-Ahmadiyya. And this is the name of Sheikh Sheiko. Huh? Men lived on earth before the advent of Adam. So this is a group of Muslims, not only the Ahmadiyya, by the way. There is other groups. There is many groups. Because the Quran, as I said, it's a collection of stupidity. How Allah, he says, I'm going to create someone who is going to inherit the earth if there is no people to inherit. Unless there is people and Adam is going to inherit them. But the fact that the confusion happened in the Quran is based on the manuscript, or let's say there's no the Quran, by the way, there's no manuscript of it, not even a single one. You remember the one they found in Birmingham, dated to the time of Muhammad? Even this one is not manuscript, for this is a piece of leather. The date of it is going even before Muhammad date, because you know in the old days they used to use the same piece of leather. They wash it, they write in it again, and they wash it. So there's something more important. They wash the old one. They do like a wash, normal wash with water, you know. So they take the ink and they write a new ink. However, even this one, they found it. The Muslims, they were so happy. It is not the same as the Quran today. In the same time, it have dots, which means it's not from the time of Muhammad, because in the time of Muhammad, the Arabic have no dots and they have no vowels. So the Muslims, they are separated to many parties, and everyone have his own fantasy. So group of the Muslims, a bigger group of them, believe that Muhammad, when he told them about Adam, he never said that Adam was the first man. Why? Because the Quran said that Allah will create a man to inherit, and you cannot inherit something unless there is somebody on it before you. But the fact it was a dot added to the Quran, you know, instead of there's Khalifa and there's Khalifa, so the same written, but because we add a dot, that will change the whole meaning of the words. And actually, there's tons of verses in the Quran have the same problems, and the Muslims today are confused with it. So when the Muslim they speak about Adam as a prophet, not only it is stupid, not only it's confusing, not only it's not logical, it is crazy and out of any logic. Because even now, even those who believe that Adam was not the first man, as long Allah he killed all the men before him, all the people before him, that means still he cannot be a prophet to anyone, because simply there's only him, right? You see how many you know, people they believe in that, and has a problem with the way children of peace were Adam and Eve the first human. Yeah, anyway, so everybody have his own fiction story. But if you read it carefully, like if you read the Bible, it's the Bible is very simple. God created Adam, created Eve, that's it. There's no people before, there's no people you know. And even Muhammad himself, he said in the hadith that Allah created the first thing he created is the dirt in Saturday. Let us see here. And he created Adam in Friday afternoon. All right, as you see it. So even the hadith confirming that. But because the Quran is a confusing book, and because there's many mistakes in writing mistake mostly, which means script mistake, like the error in writing. So now the Muslims, they have a wrong words, have nothing to do with what Muhammad even said in his time. As you see, Muhammad, he said clearly that the first thing Allah he created, it was the dirt, and the last thing he created, it was Adam Friday afternoon. And here, actually, I don't know when I forget to mention how stupid this statement is, because Muhammad, he forget Eve. You know what I mean? But an average person who read, he would not notice that. How you say that the last thing, the last creation of the last hour, it was Adam? So what about Eve? You know what I mean? Read it. It's obvious error. So I don't blame the Muslims for being confused. Muhammad is a crazy madman, false prophet. He copies stories from here and there, and he tried to glue it together. This is why those stories, they don't make sense. And you do not know even the beginning from the end. You do not know where is the middle. You do not know where is the start. You do not know who is the director. You do not know who is the hero. You do not know who died. Even Jesus, he died, but he did not die. Allah, he cloned Jesus. Like, did he die or he did not die? It's like, you know, those fiction stupid movies, you see them like the Game of the Throne, you know, the God of many faces. So Allah is the God of many faces. He have many faces for Jesus. He have many faces for Adam. He have many faces for everybody. So my friend, anyone believe that Adam was a prophet is being dumb and idiot. And I say here dumb and dumb. You know, dump, you know, because people, they are collecting their knowledge from trash. And nobody want to use his head. I mean, God, he gave us a gift. It's called a brain. Use it. This is why I believe that Muslims, their brains is the most expensive, because it never been used. Thank you very much for watching the video. And may the Lord bless you all. And sorry, Muslim, I don't mean really to insult. However, the truth hurt. Your religion is stupid. And it's not my fault if it is. Ask yourself how you are going to follow such a prophet. Ordering Adam and Eve to build a house so they can circulate around? I mean, are you serious? Do I need to circulate around the house to worship God? Hey God, I want a house to circulate too. What is that? Circle? Circulate around the house? And this is supposed to how you worship God. Why? Is the God in the house? I mean, this is a small, stupid, dumb story. Crazy. But what you can do for people, they swallow garbage. So don't accept anything will come out except garbage. Garbage in, garbage out. Thank you for listening. May the Lord bless you all. And see you soon again with more videos. Christ is Lord, Islam is false. Amen to that. See you soon again.